Kathy, watch the level of your hands. There's a bit of a drop. Watch the angle of your body. You're getting a lot of your reach at the end of the slide, not the beginning. And watch your seat. It comes down to the end and starts moving back towards the bow before the oar goes into the water. You need to get that catch in there first. You're also looking around a bit. Catherine, faster hands out of bow. Kathy needs that too. Faster hands, faster body angle out of bow. Jill, watch the level you're pulling your hands at. See how it starts in at the right depth and then pulls down and washes the oar out of the water. And your oar handle lines up in your lap without having pushed it down there. Also, you notice that when your side of the boat is down, you've got your hands way low. You should be holding that up a little bit. Julie, notice how high you're holding your hands, keeping your oar on the water, even though your side of the boat is high. You should have that oar in the air under those circumstances, not touching the water. We talked a lot last night about your, or this morning rather, about rowing style, so most of the things I would say were there. But look at the levels you're pulling the oar at. It's never a constant level going across. As we pass the picture behind the boat, the sun will be behind you, making it hard to see, but watch the heads on the center line. Kathy and Catherine, you, the two of you are showing whole faces to me around the coxswain and each other. There's way too much movement to the side. We want you on the center line. Watch this spread. We can't see Catherine, now we can see all of her face. And that shouldn't be happening. It should be a constant amount, whatever angle we're at. Watch the timing of the oars going into and out of the water. Hard to see in this picture. We'll get better at it later.
Too much sunshine there.
Catherine, as we shoot this beach, watch the connection between your slide and your oar handle. I think it could be stronger. Your slide seems to be moving without the equivalent force on the oar handle. And I think that's to be done by engaging your back sooner.
Jill, relax your death grip on the oar handle. You're actually preventing it from squaring up, which is why it's having troubles going in.
Through this section, we're going to back off and pay attention to how the bodies are moving together or not. Julie, I want you to think about rotating at the hips. Think of your back as hinged at the hips so you get a little more reach forward there. I know we talked about losing weight will help a lot too for the flexibility. But think about hinging at the hip.
Everybody in the boat, think about slowing your slide as you go down so it's constantly decelerating.
short stretch here. The boat is riding pretty well level, not too much missing there. And the timing in and out of the water is pretty good. The combination of those two makes it look pretty good right here. The bodies seem to be swimming pretty much together. We could have Julie get a little quicker out of bow, and Kathy could still get her whole lean at the start of the slide instead of the end of it.
Before you come out of bow. That's better.
But really, not bad looking for balance here because the timing is better.
Okay, Sam, go ahead.
Quicker hands and body out of bow right here. Notice how slow you're coming out. I'd like that whole lean right away before you come down the slide. Really quick hands out of bow. Brandon, yours could be a little quicker too. Nice looking stroke there. Alex, take a look at your hands on the pull through. It's what I call a camel stroke. It's got a hump in the middle. It should be level as you pull that oar. What you're doing is going deeper and then coming out, washing out. Mike, we could use a little more body lean out of you. Dale, take a look at the arch in your back. Think of hinging yourself at the hips, not in the middle of the back, so that you get the lean from the hips and lean back from the hips and keep the back pretty much straight. Think of sitting up with your head well away from your shoulders, your ears away from your shoulders. Bruce, for just a couple trips with this, that's looking pretty nice. Be a little better if it was consistent. It looks like you're checking a bit, coming down the slide and then waiting. So slow your slide down a bit for that. Now a little quicker hands out of bow. That one was better. Jamie, you're getting a little bit extra lean right at the end and it's causing you to sky your oar because you're dropping your hands.